all kids are pretty much gangsters. Yeah, right? Like, if they're under the age of, like, 8, they're like, hey, this is what I want. If not, we're going to have a problem. Like, I remember my mom making me a peanut butter and jelly. I'm like, what's this? She's like, it's peanut butter and jelly. I'm like, did you cut it in half? Triangles, lady, triangles. My mom does triangles. Right? Like, little kids, they don't know how to do anything, but and they're not nice about it. They're like, hey, lady, tie it. Come on, toots, let's go. Don't you dare kiss me in front of the guys. Tie the shoe and let me go play. Like, I have nephews. I just saw them in June. I'm going to have a little brother on the way in September. So I'm going home again. I'm not lying. It's a month from now. I'm already planning the gifts. Because here's the thing. Yeah. If you have, listen to me. I'm about to improve your life. If you go to a house, parents, back me up on this. Kids run that house like gangsters run turf. If you show up empty-handed, they take it as a sign of disrespect. They expect something. Candy, cash, a toy, something. Right? Like, the 7-year-old's older. He's okay. The 4-year-old waits for me on top of the steps like Al Capone in The Untouchables. He's like... Uncle Steve, what did you bring me? I see empty hands. I know you didn't disrespect me in my house. You left it in the car, right? There's a lot of stuff in the car. I see you on television. You don't let me wet my beak? I don't think so. Frankie, burn his car to the ground next time you bring tribute. They're the greatest. And he's so awesome because he's like a little gangster. If you get him a gift, he's like, you know what, Uncle Steve? I appreciate this. Ask around. I know how to return a favor. I'm like, what? It's like, come on, let's take a walk. I'm like, where are we going, buddy? I want to show you something. And he walks me into the kitchen, and we stop in front of the refrigerator, and he goes, welcome to my art gallery. You see anything you like? Whatever you want. It's yours. Look, I got a monster truck. You want a monster truck? I do zombies. That was supposed to be the Hulk. Didn't turn out too good. I don't want you to... How about this? A dinosaur. Take it home. Glitter and macaroni. Don't tell anybody where you got it. The greatest? If you get him a toy he really, really wants, he gets so excited. He's like, you know what? Forget it. Custom piece. Whatever you want me to draw, I'm going to... That's when you know. That's when you know a little kid loves you is when they do artwork. He's like, did my mom even offer you anything to drink? Mom, 2 apple juices. Come on. I'm embarrassed for her. Can we... Uncle Steve comes all the way. You don't offer him an apple juice. So now he has all of his art supplies over the entire table. And he's like, what do you want me to draw? I could do a pumpkin. You want to see a pumpkin? No, you don't want a pumpkin. Ooh, I got it. Close your eyes. Hold out your hand. When you open your eyes, you're going to be staring at a turkey. I know. It sounds crazy. It sounds crazy. But I can make it happen. And he was like, ooh, I got it. Don't move. I'm going to draw you. Never let that happen. Never, ever. Ever let a child draw you unless you want to know what you really look like. Because they're too honest to lie. He's too honest. He was like, here's your big tummy you always hide with sweaters. And your sad, sad eyes ever since you broke up with Karen. Everybody's talking about it. Everybody knows. I don't know where moms get the energy to put up with those little guys. If there's any moms in here, I'll give you a round of applause. Give it up for moms. Moms. Moms do everything. When I was like 3-4 years old, I thought my mom was magic because she could make a sandwich. I didn't know how. I remember just watching her. And I'm like, how does she do it? My little brother's like, I don't know. Like, I grew up with brothers, so food was a big deal in our house. Like, in my house growing up, food didn't last. the older you were, the fatter you were, because it was rules of the jungle. Whoever could eat the fastest could eat more. Like, my dad was fat. My big brother was fat. I was chubby. My poor little brother, Mark, he was so skinny that when he got excited, you could actually see his heart beating in his chest. Because people would be like, that's not true. So my big brother would, like, trick him to take his shirt off. Like, Mark, show the guys your muscles. He's like, okay, here we go. And people would be like, oh, my God. You can see it. And then he'd be like, I hate you, Chris. And then his heart would start going like that. My big brother, Chris, was a jerk. That's a big brother's job. Right. If there's any older siblings in here, round of applause. Back me up on this. Okay. Big brothers, big sisters, you have to be mean. It's rules of the jungle. That's what family is. Family's as mean as possible to each other. And you still have to love the person the next day. That's like it. The truth is, think back to your childhood. If you treated a stranger as poorly as you treated your brothers and sisters, you'd be in jail right now. Jail, hard prison. In my house, every day a felony was committed. Every day, extortion, blackmail, assault, battery, arson, more than once. We had Roman candles. There was an incident. Attempted murder, ninja stars, Rambo knives, sticks in a bike. It all happened. That's what family is. So my big brother, Chris, was the quintessential older brother. He was mean, he was fat, and he was a genius. He was so smart. He was one of those kids that everybody, like my parents would be like, your big brother, Chris, he's just bored with school. That's why he doesn't get good grades. He's so smart, he just doesn't apply himself. My little brother's like, that's a lie. So Chris finally gets a good report card, because this is what happened. The whole world came out to kiss his ass, and they're like, Chris, if you get straight A's, you can get whatever you want. He's like, okay, deal. 3 months later, they're cleaning off space on the fridge. They're moving the clowns I drew so they could put his report card up there. And then everybody's kissing his ass. Then the phone call comes in from Mom and Pop-Pop, and he takes it right in front of me and Mark. He's like, whatever I want, Mom, how about special big brother weekend without the little guys? And we're like, son of a fish. Friday afternoon, Mom and Pop-Pop come to pick him up, and he's waving from the back of their car like a senator. He's like, so long, suckers. I'm going to Shangri-La. So he shows up the next day just bragging about everything he got to do. He's like, we went out to lunch and had Chinese food. And Marky was like, that's not even real. And Chris goes, oh, yeah? Smell my breath. What is that? And he goes, that's probably the egg roll. And I'm like, Chinese people make eggs on rolls? He's like, it's not that kind of roll, dummy. It's not for sandwiches. Well, what kind of roll is it? It's called an appetizer. And I was like, oh, yeah? What's an appetizer? And he was like, that's food you have before more food. I was like, oh, shit. And Mark, he's like, well, what makes an egg roll so delicious? He's like, what makes it so delicious? Imagine thinly pressed Chinese dough, deep fried to crisp deliciousness. And then when it's finally cooled off enough, you bite into it, and there's these vegetables that they can only grow in China, and tiny little shrimpy shrimps. And there's little pieces of meat that you don't even know what they are until they explode in your mouth like fireworks of deliciousness. So Mark, he's like, that does sound good. I think I'm going to have Chinese food, too. And Chris is like, you're not old enough. You have to be 9 in order to eat it. Marky was only 5. So essentially he said was, you know your whole life? You have to live it over again before you can have Chinese food. So Marky starts doing the cry talk thing. He was like, oh, I can't have Chinese food because you say I can't have Chinese food? You know what, Chris? You think you're so smart. You got straight A's on your report card. Oh, I applaud your efforts. But you know what I got on my report card? I got straight O's. And O stands for outstanding because I'm only in kindergarten. And they don't want to make the dumb kids feel bad. But I know I'm smarter than them because I know I'm smarter than you because you think you run this house, but you're not in charge. There's only one person in charge, and it's not you. It's Mom! And he ran upstairs. Now, he's 5 years old, okay? And I remember my mom was always in the kitchen. Back in the day, phones were connected to the wall. My mom was always on the phone connected to the wall. And my little brother's going, Mom, Mom. Now, look, most five-year-olds would cry. They'd cry and complain, not my little brother, Mark. He would present a case to my mom, like she was a judge sitting on a bench. I'm not making this up. He'd start getting her to say yes, like a prosecuting attorney. He'd start establishing facts. He'd be like, Mom, Mom, Marky, is it an emergency? Mom, I believe it is. For the benefit of the entire house, please hang up the phone. Marky, what happened? Okay, Mom, remember when Chris went to Mom, Mom, and Pop-Pop's house? Do I remember it? Yes, isn't it true? He was indeed there. You remember that? Yes, Marky. Okay, I'm just trying to establish so you know I'm not making that up. No. Okay. While he was there, he claims to have eaten something called Chinese food. What about it, sweetheart boy? Okay, first question, is Chinese food real? Yes, it's real, Marky. Okay, in your own words, would you say it's the most delicious food in the world? I'd say it's pretty good, Marky. Mom, that's not what I asked you. In your own words, I would say it's good. Okay, let me rephrase, Mom. Do you think I might like Chinese food? I think you might, Marky. Okay. Final question. Do you have to be 9 years old in order to eat it? No, honey. Who would say such a thing? I think we both know who would say such a thing. So that Friday night, guys, we got Chinese food, and it was amazing. Because this is what I remember. I remember being in the back seat of the car. It's a bench seat. It's the 1980s. I'm buckled in, middle child, and I'm thinking, oh, we're going to get Chinese food. It's going to be fun. My big brother's being cool. He's like, you guys are going to like it. They have meat on a stick. It's awesome. I don't want to ruin the surprises. I'm like, it better be cool. It better be cool. Trust me, dude. You'll like it. If you don't like it, I'll eat yours. And then I go, what do you mean if I don't like it? He goes, well, what if you don't like it? I'm like, oh, my God, what if I don't like it? Because normally Friday night was pizza night. We've established that joy. So I start working my dad. I go, hey, Dad, what if I don't like this Chinese food? He goes, you don't eat it. I'm like, yeah, I know. But I'm going to need to eat something. He was like, all right, buddy, we'll figure it out. And I'm like, well, Friday night's normally pizza night. And I remember him just looking in the rearview mirror. He's like, I got you, Steve-O. Look. It's one of the best moments of my life. He goes like this. He goes, if you don't like the Chinese food, we'll get pizza on the way home. I'm like, what? Pizza as a backup plan? I felt like Versace, Versace, Versace. Ooh, ooh! I'm Vegas VIP popping bottles. Yeah, son. So we pull up to the China Palace. And I'm 6, 7 years old, and I could feel the mysteries of the Orient emanating from this building. There's neon signs, stuff written in Chinese. There's like silk lanterns hanging in the window. And I remember, like, what's going on in here? My dad opens the door. There's bells on the back of the door. Cling, 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 cling. I step in. It's deserted. And I saw three things that stood out in my mind. They were in that Chinese restaurant. They've been in every Chinese food restaurant since. Look for them. There's always a piece of bamboo. It could be a little stick or a giant tree. Look for the bamboo. There's always a ceramic desk squad kitty keeping away evil spirits. And there's always a fish tank. There's always a fish tank. There's always a fish tank that hasn't been cleaned since Reagan took a bullet. They're disgusting. And I thought that was the food. I'm like, dude, I'm not eating a goldfish. My dad's like, relax, buddy. It's just for show. I'm like, I don't care. I'm not eating it. There's a curtain behind the counter, okay? There's a glass thing. There's the desk squad kitty. There's a curtain that goes into the restaurant. My dad rings the bell. I don't see how, like, out of nowhere, this guy just appears and he goes, welcome to the China Palace. I'm like, oh, are you a ninja? And the guy's like, chubby, no, I'm not a ninja. And he shakes my head. My little brother is mortified. He's like, sir, excuse Steve's ignorance. Steve, ninjas are Japanese. This man's clearly Chinese. He was like, skinny, you smart, but chubby, you my funny guy. And they, okay, so now, he opens the curtain. There it is, a 15-foot golden dragon. You're 6 years old and you see, I was like, mother effing dragon! Oh my God, he's walking us through the restaurant. I'm six, I know illegal activities are going on in the back. I can feel it. I know guys are smoking opium and gambling, like boom ow, boom ow. Russian roulette, pit bulls about to fight, Sons of Anarchy are leaving with weapons. I go, hey dad, tip this guy well. We want to buy a gremlin on the way out, right? And my little brother's like, it's called a magwai. Unless you feed it after midnight, it's called a magwai. I go, dad, ask for what he said. So we sit down. The guy's bringing the crispy noodles. He's like bringing duck sauce. Be careful of the hot mustard. There's a horoscope thing. You're the dragon. I'm trying to figure, I don't know. Next thing I know, the maitre d' claps his hands. And four guys come from all four corners of the restaurant with the menus. The menus look like something Indiana Jones found in a cave. They were like giant red leather menus with a golden dragon on the front. It took two little hands to even open it. And I didn't even know where to look because there was stuff written in Chinese. There was combination plates like A, B, C, one of these, one of those. I'm six, Curious George is kicking my ass. I'm like, where are the pictures? And I just hear my little brother starting to laugh. And he goes, Steve, look what they have. I'm like, what? He goes, poo, poo, platter. I was like, oh my God. He's like, we need two people. I'm like, damn Skippy, what's with a poo poo? So we're going, poo, 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 poo. 4 minutes later, they bring a tray of food fit for a sultan. There's shrimp this big. There's meat on a stick. There's egg rolls. There's everything. And the guy was like, poo, poo, platter. We're like, this is awesome. He's like, back away, guys, back away. We're like, what? And whoo, he lit the middle of the tray on fire. The middle of the live fire. They brought live fire to a table. I'm 6 years old. I see a dragon. They bring me fire. And the guy was like, hey, chubby, before you leave, here's a cookie that tells the future. Yes, Chinese food. It was the greatest night ever. The great.